Alright, hello and welcome to a game that I literally just bought for $5 on Steam sale. I'm going to go ahead and do a quick let's play of it because I hear it's extremely short and has an amazing story, which is something I look for in a game. So yeah, I'm just going to do this real quick. And I know I should be getting back to Dark Mod, Splinter Cell, Saints Row the Third, Minecraft, although that kind of screwed up, all that stuff. But I just want to do this because I've heard great things about this game from my friends and such, and already looks amazing. Graphics and music, just, oh, especially music. That was really cool right there.
Dear Esther, the gulls do not land here anymore. I've noticed that this year they seem to shun the place. Maybe it's the depletion of the fishing stock driving them away. Perhaps it's me. When he first landed here, Donnelly wrote that the herds were sickly, and their shepherds the lowest of the miserable classes that populate these Hebridean islands. 300 years later, even they have departed.
Got it? Wow. The graphics are really good, actually. Wow. Okay. Let's see. Music's also pretty amazing. Ooh, that's scary. If I remember correctly, this is, in fact, Source Engine. Wow. This looks really good for the Source Engine, especially in terms of textures. Wow. Whoa! What? Oh, okay, so F is flashlight. Right? Wait. What the hell? Oh, whenever I go into dark spot. Oh, that's nice. It's automatic. Sweet. Okay. Left or right? Left or right? I've been taught to take the low ground before the high ground because the high ground is usually where you're supposed to go. So, let's move then. Ooh, that's cool. Unfortunately, there is no run button in this game, but I like that given that we need to, what's the word? Embrace the story a whole lot more, and it would be hard to do that if you're just speeding through everything. Ooh. The textures are amazing, actually. The water looks pretty good, too. And the lighting, wow. I'm impressed so far. No legs. Ah, that's okay. Kind of reminds me of Myst, actually. This is gonna suck, because I'm gonna get all the way over here and then realize I was supposed to go the other way. That's probably what's gonna happen. Wow, yeah, the water looks great. Yep. I'm gonna get over here and realize I have to go all the way back. Probably cut the footage. Oh, no. Oh, sweet. Thank you so much. You don't have to feel like an idiot. Ooh, wait.
At night, you can see the lights sometimes from a passing tanker or trawler. From up on the cliffs, they are mundane. But down here, they fugue into ambiguity. For instance, I cannot readily tell if they belong above or below the waves. The distinction now seems banal. Why not everything and all at once? There's nothing better to do here than indulge in contradictions whilst waiting for the fabric of life to unravel.
What's this thing? Oh, is it an arrow? Looks like an arrow. This way. Okay. Wow. Music's great. And I do have my mouse sensitivity set really low. Usually, I like to have my mouse sensitivity really high, but that tends to be for action games and such where I actually need to turn fast.
I found myself to be as featureless as this ocean, as shallow and unoccupied as this bay, a listless wreck without identification. My rocks are these bones, and a careful fence to keep the precipice at bay. Shot through me caves. My forehead a mount. This aerial will transmit into me so. All overexposed, the nervous system, where Donnelly's boots and yours and mine still trample. I will carry a torch for you. I will leave it at the foot of my headstone. You will need it for the tunnels that carry me under.
Well, crap. We have to go back all the way. I will cut the footage until I get there. Since I walk so damn... Alright, we're back over by this staircase. Wow, pretty. I mean, there's some games where I'm like, man, this actually looks like real life. And I mean, some examples of that, I guess, Skyrim, with all the mods I have installed, can sometimes look real. Let's see what else. I don't know. Just Cause 2 at times. But this game, so far, yeah, I can... It looks pretty amazing. I think it's more the graphic style than the graphic quality itself in this game. Like,
Donnelly's book had not been taken out from the library since 1974. I decided it would never be missed as I slipped it under my coat and avoided the librarian's gaze on the way out. If the subject matter is obscure, the writer's literary style is even more so. It is not the text of a stable or trustworthy reporter. Perhaps it is fitting that my only companion in these last days should be a stolen book written by a dying man.
Anyway, but I think the graphic style is very good in that there are lots of shrubs.
When someone had died or was dying, or so ill they gave up what little hope they could sacrifice,
we'll talk in a minute.
They cut parallel lines into the cliff, exposing the white chalk beneath. You could see them from the mainland or the fishing boat, and notice and aid, or impose a cordon of protection, and wait a generation until whatever pestilence stalked the cliff path died along with its hosts. My lines are just for this, to keep any would-be rescuers at bay. The infection is not simply of the flesh.
Okay, since last time when we took the bottom road, we will take the top road now and hopefully not run into the same problem. Oh, wait,
we are not like Lot's wife, you and I. We feel no particular need to turn back. There's nothing to be seen if we did. Mm-hmm. No tired old man parting the cliffs with his arms. No gifts or Bibles laid out on the sand for the taking. No tides turning or the shrieking gulls overhead. The bones of the hermit are no longer laid out for the taking. I have stolen them away to the guts of this island, where the passages all run to black, and where we can light each other's faces by their strange luminescence.
I figured out what the shrubs and such are. They're, I think the word is sprites, where they're facing you no matter what, so that's why they're like freaking out when I do this. But this is done really well in this case, in that when you walk through them, they turn, so it's like you're actually going through them. And I think this is a game that has succeeded in doing that, and others haven't. And also, the sprites themselves look like they're 3D objects, rather than just being, like, just kind of sitting there, like in Just Cause 2. So yeah, can't believe I'm comparing this game to Just Cause 2, but whatever. Anyway, it's probably going to start talking any second now. Wow, that looks really good.
Dear Esther.
Oh, there you go.
I met Paul. I made my own little pilgrimage. My Damascus, a small semi-detached on the outskirts of Wolverhampton. We drank coffee in his kitchen and tried to connect to one another. Although he knew I hadn't come in search of an apology, reason, or retribution, he still spiraled in panic, thrown high and lucid by his own dented bonnet. Responsibility had made him old. Like us, he'd already passed beyond any conceivable boundary of life. I find myself increasingly unable to find that point where the hermit ends and Paul and I begin. We are woven into a sodden blanket, stuffed into the bottom of a boat to stop the leak and hold back the ocean. My neck aches from staring up at the aerial. It mirrors the dull throb in my gut where I am sure I've begun to form another stone. In my dreams, it forms into a perfect representation of Lot's wife, head over her shoulder, staring along the motorway at the approaching traffic in a vacuum of fatalistic calm.
I'm so completely baffled at the texture quality. I mean, I could read that paint thing back there. It's amazing. Wow. I'm puzzled. Where am I supposed to go? Yeah, I guess, is there a way some way to go out here, like towards the boat. Maybe I can get in the water. I'm thinking about this too hard. This isn't a platform game. Oh hey! Whoa! Oh god! That was scary. I wonder if you actually do have to swim. I know where I'm going. It's probably supposed to do something there. I don't know. I don't think this is a puzzle game. Pretty certain that this is a straight adventure. No! Swim up! I'm trying to swim up! What's going on? Oh, I can't do it.
I'm
trying! What happened? Okay, I'm not supposed to go that way. Very well. Ooh, this way looks promising. See that? Okay, so water bad. This really isn't the game for doing a Let's Play too. I think I figured that out. Wow. That's pretty. Yeah, but basically, I think this Let's Play is going to consist of me, like, being in awe at the graphics and talking about how much this guy talks. I think he's going to talk in a second now because I've moved on to a new section. Am I going towards that red light? Oh, it's not red. Oh, there it goes. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm going towards that. Okay. Oh! I don't want to do that.
I dreamt I stood in the center of the sun, and the solar radiation cooked my heart from the inside. My teeth will curl, and my fingernails fall off into my pockets like loose change. If I could stomach, I'd eat, but all I seem capable of is salt water. Were the livestock still here, I could turn feral and gorge. I'm as emaciated as a body on a slab, opened up for a premature source of death. I've rowed to this island in a heart without a bottom, all the bacteria of my gut rising up to sing to me.
This is amazing. I love the poetic sound of the writing so far. That would be a Bible. I think we're just gonna follow the gravel big brick road. The gravel road, whatever you want to call it. Just the sheer amount of different types of foliage is amazing. It's just like, I don't see anything repeated over here. It's incredible. Or it is repeated and it's just masked by everything else. Really incredible. Really well done. Yeah, I mean, this looks like a picture someone took. It's amazing. Wow. This game's so cinematic. I love cinematic quality games, like sort of LA Noire, but oh, is that the end of the first chapter? Sweet. There are only four. We could be done with this in an hour. I think that's how long it took Doug. So yeah. Shouldn't take that long.
Dear Esther, I have now driven the stretch of the M5 between Exeter and Bristol over 21 times. But although I have all the reports and all the witnesses, and have cross-referenced them within a millimeter using my ordnance survey maps, I simply cannot find the location. You'd think there would be marks to serve as some evidence. It's somewhere between the turnoff for Sanford and the welcome break services. But although I can always see it in my rearview mirror, I have as yet been unable to pull ashore.
Wow. Okay, is that a crashed boat? That is amazing looking from a distance. Holy crap. Wow. Screw the pathway. I'm gonna get to this thing. Yo, okay, why would you make a pathway like this? I mean, I understand that for switchbacks, but this is not a steep... whatever. Maybe that isn't a pathway. Maybe it's a drive-in from